Mrs. Melody Angel, mm-hmm. Hello and welcome in Belgium.
Thank you.
I think it's your first time that you are here in Belgium?
Yes, my first time. Right.
What did you knew about Belgium?
A
small country somewhere in Europe?
I knew it was a small country somewhere in Europe. That's what I knew.
Some names of musicians in Belgium?
No, I didn't know. I didn't know any specific bands that were from Belgium or anything.
Yeah, not that famous as all the American bands. That's no problem.
Okay.
like I said, it's Melody Angel, and a lot of people think that is your stage name.
Right. Yeah, I have to tell people all the time. Nope, it's on my birth certificate. I swear. I probably have to just show it every now and then. Like, see.
It's
my name.
It's a rather unusual name.
Yeah, it fit. Yeah, I think it was just meant to be.
Yeah. Did you, as a young girl, raise up in a musical family or environment?
Oh, yeah. My mom's side of the family, like, almost everybody sings. Ooh. And if they can't sing, they play an instrument. Yeah. So, I mean, my mom, she sang, and a lot of my uncles sang, my aunties sang or played an instrument, so I grew up around singers and musicians,
mm-hmm.
and so it's always been in my life.
So I can say in a way that you were destined to become a musician.
I feel like that because nothing else has ever felt, I've never been sure about anything else.
It's the only thing that you did in your life, singing and making music.
It just felt good and natural, and I didn't have to try, and that was really something.
You grew up as a black young child in Chicago.
Yeah, yeah.
Was that a hard time?
I mean, well, Chicago's hard by itself. It's just you have to be really smart to be a black youth in Chicago. You can't afford to make mistakes.
Mistakes.
You don't really get second chances. And so you really have to be smart with who you hang out with all of the choices you make. So you don't really get to be a child in the sense of like, I'm just going to do something crazy one day, because you could literally end up dead.
That affects your future, thinking, your
everything
plans.
That you do, you know, it's like, it's really life or death. And a lot of people don't really realize how extreme it is. And it sounds extreme, but it really is. Yes. Because, I mean, I've lost family members and friends because they decided to go to a party that turned out to be that turned into something else. So they were sitting on their porch, mm-hmm. and a drive back came, you know. You can't be out too late. You can't go here. You can't go there. Mm-hmm. So it's a lot of choices you got to make.
But on the other side, it helped you too to survive.
Oh, yeah. It definitely made me a stronger person, and I really think things through no matter what, and that's helped me.
You are a musician. Does music help you to communicate?
Oh,
to
yeah.
Say some things to?
I'm a real laid back person, so sometimes I don't say like how I'm feeling and what I'm going through. But I found that when I wrote songs, I could get everything out. Everything that I don't say out loud, I could get out in a song.
And you're sure that the people understand what you wanted to say or to
After
teach.
I would do a show, people would come up to me and specifically say, oh, that song really touched me, and they'll say why. And what ends up happening is we tell each other stories that connect us. When I do a song, they're like, yeah, it reminded me of this,
mm-hmm.
or when this happened in my family. So it's been really amazing to see how many people connect.
I read somewhere that everything started with songs of Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah.
Is that the right story?
Well, for me, guitar started with Prince and Michael Jackson, because that's just who I heard first right off the bat. And then Prince led me to Jimmy, and that just opened up everything. And I kind of learned, because I learned guitar by ear, so I kind of learned how to bend strings and how to, you know, do pull-offs and all those little things he did. He was like the best teacher, because he did everything.
And you still know the songs that
Oh yeah, I do Jimmy at every show. I try to just keep it down to one or two songs, because I could just do a whole set of Jimi Hendrix songs. I mean, I could go through, I probably should do that once, just do all Jimmy songs one night.
You know Jeff Jensen? He's an American guitarist. He also, every show he does, Jimi Hendrix songs.
Yeah, I never do a set without doing one of his songs.
And then at a certain moment you wanted to write your own songs.
Right.
Was that a difficult process or difficult thing to do that?
Not really. I think just because since I started singing when I was really young, like 7 or 8, I started writing songs even mm-hmm. then. Like I would just make up songs and write them and do everything. And then years when I was like 14 and 15, got my guitar, I put music to it. But I was already writing. So that was I put the two together very early on.
Just, you don't write on specific moments or no? You're always busy with things in your head, yeah.
Always.
I want to go back to your first album, mm-hmm. In the Fire. That's 2017, I think.
16, yeah.
Oh, 16 or 17.
I put out an EP before that.
Maybe
that was
released
like
in 17, but yeah. But, one of the songs, also the song of your EP, In This America.
Yeah.
It sounds a bit as a call. A demand for attention. Is that a right interpretation or?
Well, for me, it really didn't start that way.
What did you want to put in it, in that specific song?
I just was I remember when I wrote In This America, I was very emotional because a lot of horrible things was happening in my community in America. Of course, it was just like every other week, it was another black man killed for being black, mm-hmm. and nothing happening. Police getting off, no charges, or they do the whole trial and let the guy go. I mean, it was just this onslaught mm-hmm. of names of innocent people dying. And at one point, there was a guy, I always mess up his name, but Philando, he got shot just sitting in his car, and it was all on tape, and I actually saw it on Facebook live. Mm-hmm. And I was like, that was the first time I ever saw anybody die, like live. And mm-hmm. it was unbelievable how evil it all seemed, you know, and it just broke my heart. So when I just wrote it to get things off of my chest, and I'm not some big artist, so you don't think of anybody really hearing your music. Oh. It was just something I did. I wrote the song, I put it up on YouTube, and I didn't initiate anything with it. It just sort of, whoever heard it was affected like I was affected. They felt what I was feeling. They connected with what I was saying.
Because in the song you are wondering how safe it is to have a song.
Yeah, I mean, that's what, when you're young and you haven't had your family yet, and you're looking at all these young black men getting killed, it's like, well, what if I have a son?
Yeah.
What's going to happen to him? What am I supposed to, how am I supposed to feel about that? So I was really trying to figure that out.
How different is your latest album? It's called The Woman Blues.
Yeah, this is another EP, and it's just kind of getting me, I wanted to put something out that I...
Something for the women, or?
Well, just something. I just wanted to put out something while I was working on my next album. Mm-hmm. And I had this idea. I had already had the song, A Woman's Blues. And I was like, okay, I think I have enough songs to kind of put a little EP together mm-hmm. that goes with that. Because I really loved the song and what I was saying. And in the era of Trump and all his crap against women and everything, once again, it's just like you just got to use what's going on in your life, yeah. And that's what I've always tried to do.
Can you give us, and I give you now free promotion time, a few reasons why we should buy the album?
Well, I think if you want music that sounds good and has something to say, you should check me out sometime.
That's a good reason.
Yeah.
What are your plans for the near future?
Well,
is it your only show here in Belgium, or are you trying to get?
I mean, hey, I'm definitely open to coming back. I tell you, I'm always looking for shows, gigs. You know, I just want to perform as much as possible, and so you just kind of have to keep putting yourself out there and letting people know that you're willing to come out and play, and hopefully they contact me.
Because Westmalle is one of the free open air concerts, so
right.
We don't have to pay for it. So
right, right.
There will be a lot of people, I think.
Yeah, yeah,
the weather, I mean, the weather is good, so.
That's awesome. I'd be very interested.
If you could do it over again, would you do something different, or would you do it again?
There's nothing else. I mean, for me, I mean, I've recently gotten into acting, just like on, you know, but that just kind of happened just because I don't even know how that happened, but somebody thought I had some talent in that, and I did that a little bit in a theater production of Father Comes Home from the Wars, at the Goodman Theater in Chicago, which is like a really big theater in Chicago, and that kind of opened up some new doors for me. But music is my first passion and love, and I'm just now seeing that I am interested in other things, but nothing is above music.
You are rather young, I can say. Do you still have open items on your to-do list, on your bucket list?
I always call it. Yeah, I got a bunch of stuff.
Things that you surely want to do?
Yeah, I mean, I've never been on a tour.
Ooh.
So I've only, like, if I go out to things, it's just like this one show. Like now, this is just this one show, and then I go back home. So my big goal is to actually go on a tour.
Also specific places where you want to go?
Yeah, I want to go all over Europe,
Paris,
you know.
London.
Yeah, I want to see the world,
yeah,
you know.
That's right.
So that's my big goal.
Before I ask you my last question, I must first congratulate you.
Oh.
I read somewhere that you are not only a musician, but you do also some things in film.
Yeah, yeah.
In the film Knockout.
Yeah,
tell us something more? You got the prize for it.
So I was, after I did the play at the Goodman Theater, some of the guys on the video team at the Goodman asked me to be in this short film project. It's called the 48-hour film project. Basically, you have to make a film in 48 hours and submit it to a contest.
Project, yes.
Yeah. And so we did it, and it was a film called Knockout, and they wanted me to star in it, and I was playing a boxer, and her family didn't want her boxing, of course, because she's a woman, and they didn't want her getting hurt in the ring and this and that. And we ended up winning the film project. So we're,
the best picture.
Yeah, best picture for Chicago, and so the film is going to go up into the International Film Festival that they're gonna have, and I mean, it's
pretty crazy. But you
didn't
need to sing in it, or just
just acting, and that was my first time on camera, and I was like, wow.
Great, that I read somewhere. Okay, So I have a last question.
Yeah.
What did you learn about yourself by being a musician, from your music? Did you learn things?
I learned from my music and my little journey that I've had so far, I learned a lot of confidence, because I didn't know if I could teach myself how to play guitar. I just knew I really wanted to. But I didn't know if I could pull that off. And I didn't know if I could find musicians that would play with me. I just didn't know how to do any of this. I just knew I wanted to do it. So it was always like I was proving to myself that I could figure it out, that I was stronger than I thought I was. And that's like the biggest thing that music has taught me, because it gave me that confidence to do something like a movie, just out of the blue. Okay, just do it, because what's the worst that could happen? But I learned that doing all this music stuff, like, I didn't know how to accomplish any of this, how to book gigs or anything. I just figured it out.
Yeah. Okay. Like I told you, that this were my questions. Perhaps I forgot to ask you something. I don't know.
This was nice.
So I must thank you again for your time, and thank you for your lovely music.
Thank you.
I hope that you have a nice and a big show tonight.
Thank you very much.